God, come to my assistance.
O Lord, make haste to help me.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Alleluia. My love, my fortress, he is my stronghold, my savior, my shield, my place of refuge. He brings peoples under my rule.
Amen. You must hold fast to faith, be firmly grounded and steadfast in it, unshaken in the hope promised you by the gospel you have heard. It is the gospel which has been announced to every creature under heaven.
What better counsel could be given to our anxious deacons this evening than the short excerpt from Paul's marvelous letter to the Colossians? You must hold fast to faith. Be firmly grounded and steadfast in it, unshaken in the hope promised you by the gospel you have heard. And in this case, the gospel you are ordained to preach. Obviously, to this point in our deacons' very young lives, this gospel has played a very important part in their history. Your history, your families, your education and life experience have all been grounded in that Catholic faith that comes from the gospel of Jesus Christ. While your own roads have been very different, they have also been very much the same. Both of you come from a life and a family grounded and steadfast in the faith that brings us to believe that God actually wants you to be a driving source of his grace in our world, that he has chosen you for that particular job in life, so to speak. A source of his word being not simply preached, but lived for all to see and to emulate. A source of his gospel and a source of his sacraments. Your faith, John and Robert, brings you tomorrow morning to kneel here in this sanctuary before Bishop Konderla and to truly know that when you rise up, you will be able to bring Christ Jesus to the wonder of the Eucharist, the compassion of reconciliation, the comfort of the anointing of the sick, and the adoption consequent to baptism. A driving source of God's grace in our world. It goes without saying that our world, both secular and in the church, desperately needs this driving force. Our secular world suffers profoundly from what I consider an inability to grasp that God truly loves and cares for each individual, that each and every person is called to life by the power and the will of God himself. We are not accidents of history. We are rather the intention of divinity. That founding stone of our Catholic faith is simply missing in our secular society. And both of you are called to penetrate that society and give comfort to that world with this good news. It is, in fact, the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. Our church, which calls you to this great sacrament of priestly orders, also finds itself at this moment in a unique time and place, needing desperately the faithful servant. The faithful servant living the priesthood in a holy and wholesome manner. So this evening, we gather here to pray with you and with your families that God will indeed pour forth his grace and his power into your lives, that you will be that faithful steward, and that you will be that embodiment of the gospel. Your parents have been wonderful examples of the power of this grace functioning in their lives. And for this, the entire Church of the Diocese of Tulsa and Eastern Oklahoma and the whole Universal Roman Catholic Church, thank you. We thank you for those years of fidelity and those years of showing forth the power of this gospel in the lives that you live and the lives to which you called your children. As God has been faithful to you, so shall he be faithful to both of our deacons as they rise tomorrow from this sanctuary to live a totally new life. God, in his wisdom, has chosen you for this service, and God, in his wisdom, has chosen you for this awesome privilege. May his grace preserve both of you in this service. Our secular world needs your message, and our church needs your ministry. So we say again tonight, you must hold fast to faith. You must be firmly grounded and steadfast in it, unshaken in the hope promised you by the gospel you have heard. May God bless and keep you, and may he let his face shine upon you, and may he give you peace.
The celebration of the mystery of the Eucharist lies at the center of the Church's life. Christ nourishes and strengthens us with his living body and saving blood, that we might be his witnesses in the world. The vessels which hold the bread and wine for the Eucharist are treated with reverence and respect, for they ultimately will contain the body and blood of the Lord. We ask for God's blessing on these vessels for the Holy Eucharist and upon us who will be fed from them. So let us pray. With joy, Lord God, we place on your altar this chalice and patens for the celebration of the sacrifice of the new covenant. May the body and blood of your Son, offered and received by means of these vessels, make them holy. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that celebrating the unblemished sacrifice, we may be renewed by your sacraments on earth and endowed with your Spirit, until with the saints we come to delight in your banquet in the kingdom of heaven. Glory and honor to you forever. Let us pray to Christ, the light of the nations, and the joy of every living creature.
Give us all peace and security. light, word of the Father, you came to save all men. Lead the catechumens of your church into your marvelous light. Overlook our sins, Lord, for you are the source of forgiveness.
Give us light, peace, and security,
Lord. It is your will that men use their minds to unlock nature's secrets and master the world. May the arts and sciences advance your glory and the happiness of all peoples. Look kindly on those who have dedicated themselves to the service of their fellow men. May they fulfill their work freely and completely.
Give us light, peace, and security, Lord.
Lord, you open the way and no one can close it. Lead into your light those who have fallen asleep in the hope of resurrection.
Give us light, peace, and security, Lord.
Informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation,
but deliver us from
evil. Lord, hear the evening prayers we bring before you. Help us to follow in the footsteps of your Son, so that we may produce an abundant harvest of goodness in patience and in faith. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Now and forever.
Our help is in the name of the Lord.
Amen. Heaven and earth.
May Almighty God bless you all, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace.
Thanks be.